It's good to see these two people who are very independent in their own right and very opinionated come together and find that they're not so different after all.
Duncan is a rock star in all the ways that you would think. He is the godfather of Outlander, and there's no way that you can't love him.
The only silver I have is in my hair.
Well, you have a heart of gold.
And that's another thing we're going to have to keep quiet about.
I'll play you for your dog.
I always was curious, hey, in the books, young Ian talks about winning Rollo, and who doesn't want to see that scene?
The odds seem to be weighted in my favor. 12.
It was like, oh, it'd be really cool to see him dicing with the sailors, and how exactly did he win this dog?
Take the wretched mongrel and your money and go. Come on, lad. You're coming with me.
Obviously, Rollo has become our MVP of the season. I think people like Rollo more than anyone else.
I could talk about Rollo all day. I met Rollo when he was still pretty much a little puppy. From that moment, we've just been best buds.
Lucky roll of the dice, eh?
Everyone's favorite part is the nice big lick on the face that he gives to young Ian.
Rollo, yes.
Good boy.
We started looking for Rollo in season 3 because we knew we'd probably have to find puppies and train them as they grew, and picked out 2 puppies. We named them McDo after a Jamie character and then Whiskey, for obvious reasons. We're in Scotland. And McDo, who we call Dewey, is the one that plays Rollo. He is the nicest dog there is, and he's never ferocious.
He had his own ways of playing his part, where he was written one way to be a little more aggressive, and Dewey is not that way. The bond between Dewey and John is actually them. They just love each other.
I am a member of his pack. We look after each other on set. He's much better behaved than I am.
Love you lots.
Chef Mark.
The chance for Outlander Untold is to tell stories that aren't necessarily in the books. Sometimes they are, but it's also with characters that we don't get to see as much of. We're still wondering about their inner lives.
I think it's really great that these Untold segments kind of give people the chance to see people that they really care about. What it all comes down to in the end is that they like the people, and they just want to know what's going on with them. I think that's very lovely.
Hi. Hey.